All right, so the title is Energy of a Graph. Okay. Now, for any graph G, the energy which we will denote by epsilon G of G is defined to be the sum of absolute values of the eigenvalues of AG. Okay. So it is just this gadget. Epsilon G is if it's an graph on n vertices, then AG is an n by n symmetric matrix. Therefore, it has n eigenvalues. Eigenvalues might be repeated. If they are repeated, still you just count them up to n, and then you add them up. Right? Sometimes all of them might be the same. Okay. We have another definition. This is linear algebra. Let A and B be matrices of size m by n and p by q respectively. The Kronecker product of A and B denoted as A tensor B, it is also called tensor product of matrices, is the matrix, is the m times p by n times q block matrix aij b. What we mean is this. Okay, this is the following matrix. So it is m by p times n by q matrix. You take A11, multiply it by b. So this is a each aij b is an this is an p by q matrix, right? You put A11b as your first block, and then you put A12b as your second block, and you go up to where A1 what was it? Size n b, and then A21b, A22b up to A2nb. And finally, UM1B, UM2B, and U, sorry, not U, AMN times B. Okay, this is the matrix, A tensor B. Here's an important fact about this. Note that you can check this easily. Actually, this is just AC times BD. BD. So this is a matrix. This is another matrix. You multiply these two matrices. It is this one. Of course, this is true provided that AC and BD are defined. Right? What do we mean by this is defined? The size of A and C should be compatible, right? For the product to exist. And similarly, the size of B and D should be compatible for the product to exist. In that case, this product is well defined, and the product is equal to this. Okay. The best way is to, prove something like this. Just take, for example, a 2 by 2 and a 3 by 3 matrix, and then just write down, both sides. You will see immediately why this is the case. Okay. Here is a lemma, which is about eigenvalues of such products. Let A and B, sorry, be symmetric matrices. So not just an arbitrary matrix, but symmetric matrices of order m by m and n by n respectively. So they might be the adjacency matrices of graphs of size or order m and n, right? Two graphs, and you have adjacency matrices if lambda 1 up to lambda m and mu 1 up to mu n are eigenvalues of A and B respectively, since A is a symmetric matrix of size m by n, it has m eigenvalues. We call them lambda 1 up to lambda m. And B is also a symmetric matrix, so it has n eigenvalues called nu 1 up to nu n. Then the conclusion is this. The eigenvalues of A tensor identity matrix plus identity tensor B matrix of appropriate sizes so that the products are defined are given by lambda I times mu j. So it is m times n eigenvalues because the size of the product is now m times n, I from 1 up to m, and mu, j from 1 up to n. So it has m times n eigenvalues, okay? And these are the eigenvalues. Proof is as follows. Okay. Since A and B are symmetric, they are diagonalizable, right? Since A and B are symmetric, they are diagonalizable. Okay. Let P and Q be matrices. They are diagonalizable in a basis, in an orthonormal basis. So the eigen vectors can be chosen to be orthogonal. Eigenvectors, sorry, orthogonal matrices such that P transpose AP is diagonal matrix lambda 1 up to lambda m, and Q transpose BQ is diagonal matrix mu 1 up to mu n, right? One of them is m by n matrix, the other one is n by n matrix. Then we have, let's see, P transpose tensor Q transpose product tensor identity plus identity tensor B P tensor Q. Now, by this remark, how do we multiply such tensors? We just multiply the matrices coordinate wise, first coordinate, second coordinate, and then we take the tensor. So this will be what? This will be just P tensor A tensor. So let me just write down. P transpose AP tensor Q transpose identity Q plus P transpose identity P tensor Q transpose BQ. Well, what is that? That's equal to P transpose P. Okay, let me write it this way. P transpose AP is just the diagonal matrix lambda 1 up to lambda m. And then this is multiplied with Q transpose identity Q. This is just Q transpose Q, but Q is orthogonal. Therefore, this is also identity, right? Orthogonal matrix, its inverse is just is its transpose. So this is just IN. And then similarly, this thing is IM tensor diagonal of diagonal matrix mu 1 up to mu n. Now, what is this? It is easy to see that this finishes the proof. Why is that? Let me just explain this on an example. So what we mean, the eigenvalues of this matrix are lambda i's plus mu j's. Why is that? Well, you see, what is this? This is just this product is equal to what? So diagonal of lambda 1 lambda m tensor identity. What is this? This is just lambda 1 times identity, right? I take this matrix 1 1 1 and then all others are 0, and then I have also this matrix, lambda 1, lambda n, all others are 0. So I have lambda 1 times this matrix, and then 0 times identity. So this is also an n by n block, n by n block up to here. And then I have zeros here, because zeros are multiplied with this. And then I have lambda 2 times identity n, and lambda n times identity, sorry, lambda m times identity n, and all others are 0, okay? What about the other one? The other one is, it was I am, and then diagonal of mu 1 up to mu n. What is this? This is just one here, and then the rest is 0. 1 times this, so I have this diagonal matrix, diagonal of mu 1 up to mu n, and then I have zeros here. Zeros here, and diagonal of mu 1 up to mu n again, and it goes up to here, diagonal of mu 1 up to mu n. What will be the sum of these two when you add them up? You see, the very first entry here is lambda 1. The very first entry here is mu 1. So the first entry of the sum will be lambda 1 plus mu 1. What about the second entry? It is 0 here. It is 0 here because these are all diagonal matrices. And it will be 0 also, you know, everything in the first column except this term will be 0. What is the second element? Well, it is lambda 1 here, but here I have diagonal of diagonal matrix consisting of mu 1, mu 2, and so on. So the second diagonal entry here is lambda 2, sorry, lambda 1, but here it is mu 2. So the second element here, lambda 1 plus mu 2. And it will go up to n, lambda 1, mu n. And then we will pass to lambda 2, lambda 2s, lambda 2, mu 1, lambda 2, mu n. And it will go up to lambda m, mu 1, and lambda m, mu n. Okay, so the diagonal entries of this tensor product will be all possible sums of eigenvalues. Therefore, the eigenvalues of that matrix is as claimed. Okay, all possible sums of eigenvalues of A and B. Tamam mı? Yani öyle açıkça yazarsanız hemen gözüküyor. Tamam mı burası? İsterseniz kalsın mı bu, silmeyeyim. Bir tane daha lemma var. Let A and B be as in the above lemma. Yani gene işte simetrik matrisler vesaire vesaire. Then the eigenvalues of A tensor B are given by tensörün eigenvalüleri ise lambda I mu j. Gene tabii ki for all I j. I 1'den m'e kadar, j 1'den n'e kadar. Bunun ispatı daha kolay. Neden? Yine let p and q be as in the proof of the above lemma. So that işte P transpose A P diagonal of lambda 1 lambda M and Q transpose B Q is diagonal mu 1 mu N. Well then P transpose Q transpose A transpose B P transpose Q, this will be what? This is just P transpose A P trans tensor Q transpose B Q. Well, this is just the diagonal matrix lambda 1 up to lambda m, and this is diagonal matrix mu 1 up to mu n. What will be the tensor product of two diagonal matrices? It will be again a diagonal matrix. You can check this real easy. It will be just lambda I mu j's, okay? I from 1 up to m, j from 1 up to n. How can you see that? You can just, you know, form something like this, and it's easy to see, real easy. Tamam mı? Şimdi şeyi hatırlayalım. İki grafın kartezyen product'ı diye bir şey tarif etmiştik. Recall that for any two graphs G and H, the Cartesian product G cross H is defined as follows. The vertex set of G cross H, vertex set of G cross H is just the vertex set of is the Cartesian product of the vertex sets of G and H, and two elements in this Cartesian products will be adjacent. So we will put an edge between any two vertices if and only if either u equals u prime and there is an edge between v and v prime, or there is an edge between u and u prime and u v and v prime are the same. Okay, this is the Cartesian product. Here, note that, so I will leave this as an exercise. The adjacency matrix, it is easy to see this. What is this? This is nothing but AG tensor identity plus identity tensor AH. Okay. Where the vertex set of G has M elements and vertex set of H has N elements. Okay. Sizes of the graphs are M and H respectively. Then we have the following consequence of the first lemma. The first lemma has the following immediate corollary. Neydi first lemma? Şeydi, hatırlarsanız bu matrisin eigenvalülerinin ne olduğunu söylüyordu. Bizim graflarda da elde ettiğimiz matris tam olarak bu. G grafının matrisi, bu da B grafının matrisi. Dolayısıyla da iki grafın eigenvalülerini biliyorsak, onların kartezyen product'ın eigenvalüleri A ile B'nin eigenvalülerinin toplamları olacak. Tamam mı? Onu söylüyor. Hemen yazalım. Şöyle diyeyim, şunu şuraya yazalım da korolları. Assume the above setup. Then the eigenvalues şöyle yazayım ya, above setup'ta şeyi söylemedik. If lambda 1 up to lambda m are eigenvalues of G, yani aslında of AG değil mi? Adjacency matrix, and new one up to new n are eigenvalues of H, then mu I plus, pardon, lambda I plus mu J's are eigenvalues of G tensor H. Here I ranges from 1 up to M, J ranges from 1 up to N. And the theorem we would like to prove is this. Let G be a graph with N vertices if the energy epsilon G of G is a rational number the sum of the eigenvalues, absolute values of the eigenvalues of the graph G, then it must be an even integer. Okay. Okay. Here is the proof. Let lambda 1 up to lambda k, right, be the positive eigen values of G. Sorry. Some of, since the matrix is symmetric, all eigenvalues are real. Some of them are positive, some of them might be negative, and some of them might be zero. But we know this since zero equals trace of A, right? For any graph, the trace of the matrix is zero. Why is that? Because the matrix A has zeros in the diagonal, right? By definition. Since the diagonal entries are zero, its trace is zero. But trace means what? Sum of the eigenvalues. Lambda 1 up to lambda k. Sorry, lambda n. So this means what? These are the positive ones. So the sum of the positive ones is equal to the sum of the negative ones, right? The sum of the positive eigenvalues is equal to the negative of the sum of the negative eigenvalues. Ki toplamı sıfır, değil mi? Negatif olanlarla pozitif olanların toplamları sıfırsa, pozitif olanların toplamıyla negatif olanların toplamı ters işaretli olmalı. Birisi diyelim ki eksi 50 ise öbürü artı 50. Peki, şimdi şunu biliyoruz. By the above lemma, lambda 1, iki tane grafın çarpımının eigenvalüleri neydi? Birincinin bir eigenvalüsünü al, ikincinin bir eigenvalüsünü al, onları topla. Şimdi ben şunu yapacağım. K tanesini çarpacağım. Is an eigenvalue of G to the power k. What we mean by this, the cross product of G with itself, Cartesian product of of G with itself, k times. So for this graph, I take the eigenvalue lambda 1, one of the positive eigenvalues. For this one, I take lambda 2. For this one, I take lambda k. I know that whenever I choose eigenvalues of these graphs, their sum is an eigenvalue of the product. Okay, so lambda 1 up to lambda k is an eigenvalue of this Cartesian product of k graphs. Well, the characteristic polynomial of the adjacency matrix of any graph, in particular G to the power k, is a monic polynomial. With integer coefficients. Because the matrix consists of integers and characteristic polynomial is always a monic polynomial, right? It starts with lambda to the power n. And then the other entries are just products of the entries of the matrix and their sums. But they are all integers. So multiplying and adding integers, you cannot get anything out of integers. So all the coefficients are integers and it's a monic polynomial. So it is something like this, okay? And it is a rational root. We assume that it is a rational root. If you have a rational root of a monic polynomial with integer coefficients, then that rational root actually should be an integer. Okay? It's probably something you have seen in abstract algebra. How do you prove this? If it is rational, then lambda is, you know, root is something like this. R and S are natural numbers or integers, and you may choose them to be relatively prime, right? The reduced form of that rational number, like 2 over 5. When you plug it here, you will get r to the power n, s to the power n, a1, r to the power n minus 1, s to the power n minus 1, up to an, right? And then clear the denominator by sn, multiplying with s to the power n, you will get this, a1, r to the power n minus 1, s, a2, r to the power n minus 2, s squared, up to an sn equals 0. Well, r and s are relatively prime, therefore r should divide r divides this term, all of them, therefore it divides this term, but it doesn't divide this one, therefore r should divide a to the power n, an, and s divides this term, and up to here, therefore s divides r to the power n, but r and s are relatively prime, therefore s should be 1, okay? S is 1, so lambda has to be integer. The denominator is 1, okay? Bunu cebirde gördünüz mü? Gauss lemma galiba. Ya da Gauss lemma mı? Yok. Eisenstein kriter miydi? Neydi? Bir şeydi ismi. Unuttum. Yani en son 30 sene önce görmüştüm herhalde. Ya Gauss ya Eisenstein. Öyle bir şey. Tamam mı? Yani fikir son derece basit. O zaman ne veriyor bu? O zaman integer bu nesne. Integer. Yazıyor muydunuz bunu? Tamam mı? Burayı sileyim o zaman. C1'den bir şey kalmasın. Pardon. Okey. Şimdi ne gördük? O zaman hence if okey. Hence any rational root of the characteristic polynomial is an integer. Ama biz de burada görmüştük, lambda 1 artı lambda k bir integerdi. Özür dilerim, bir root'tu. Bunun da rasyonel olduğunu kabul ettik. Değil mi? Rasyonel olduğunu kabul ettik. O yüzden de hence lambda 1 up to lambda k is an integer. Is an integer. So the energy of G neydi? Energy of G şuydu. Bütün şeylerin rootların lambda 1 up to lambda'nın hepsinin mutlak değerinin toplamıydı. Şimdi bu toplam neye eşittir? Pozitif olanlar var, negatif olanlar var, sıfırlar var. Ama pozitif olanların toplamıyla negatif olanların toplamı birbirinin ters işaretlisiydi. Dolayısıyla bu, this is just 2 times lambda 1 up to lambda k, right? Because the sum of the positive ones is equal to the sum of the negative ones. So, this is an integer. This is 2 times an even of an integer. Therefore, is an even integer. Okay. Enerji buydu. Belki şöyle söylemek lazım. Enerjisi şuydu zaten. Bunun iki katıydı. Bu bir rasyonel sayıysa lambda 1 lambda k toplamı rasyonel sayı. Ama bu bir polinomun kökü. Dolayısıyla integer olması gerekiyor. Demek ki lambda 1 lambda k toplamı bir integer. O halde enerji de o integer'ın iki katı. Tamam. Doğru argüman öyle. Yani şu lafı şundan sonra etmek lazım ama neyse sorun değil. Anladık. Tamam mı? Ya doğru argüman şöyle. Enerjiyi yazıyorum. Enerji 2 çarpı bu sayı. Bunlar tabii pozitif olduğu için bu şuna eşit. 2 çarpı lambda 1 artı lambda k'ya eşit. Şimdi eğer bu sayı rasyonelse o zaman bu da rasyonel. Ama lambda 1 artı lambda k bir grafın eigen value'su ve biz ne gördük? Bir grafın eigen value'su eğer rasyonel sayıysa aslında o rasyonel sayı bir tam sayı olmalı. Dolayısıyla da bu sayı lambda 1 artı lambda k bir tam sayı. Enerji de onun iki katı. Dolayısıyla bir even integer olmak zorunda. Okay. I guess we may stop.